Hello, my beautiful people. Thank you so much for tuning in for another video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Maggie, and it's always a pleasure to have you here. I would love for you to stick around by hitting that subscribe button so that you never miss another upload. But if you're here because of the title, then today we're going to be talking about our men, our spoiled ass men. Here on my channel, I do a lot of, you know, women videos. I talk about, you know, a lot of women things, right? But I'm also a wife, right? So, and I know a lot of you are also wives or, you know, in fiancés and stuff as well. So I really wanted to take a moment so that we can really stop for a second and really pay attention to our men, to our husbands, right? To our fiancés, and just give them all that good old loving that they deserve, right? Hopefully they're deserving, right? This video is not for Ray Ray and Devontae. This video is not for Marquise, okay? This video is for the good men, you know, the faithful men, the God-fearing men who just deserves all of this love that I'm about to get into right now, okay? So don't mind me, I just have my notes here so that I can stay on track because I will start to rambling and going off the deep end. So what men needs most in relationships but will not admit, number one, praise and approval. Men have very tender egos. No matter how good of a man that he is, they need frequent reassurance about themselves, their career paths, and how they are in bed, and everything else. I hear it all the time, and just, you know, with friends and family about how their women, you know, never really praise them or give them the reassurance that they need, but then the outside women, right? Every other woman is like giving them what they want, complimenting them, you know, empowering them, encouraging them, you know, and that's probably all they need. They want it to come from us, right? They don't want to hear from no other woman. They need that love and that empowerment, that encouragement and that praise and those compliments from us. Sometimes that's all they need to boost their little ego. So next time you see him, whip out your best pickup lines, your best compliments, you know, and just don't forget to tell him how great of a job that he's doing overall. My next tip, this should be explanatory, but I really feel like it's so far-fetched in most relationships nowadays, and that's simply respect. This one's kind of obvious, but like I said, I can't tell you how many people in relationships I see where the woman is just totally disrespectful. The woman is just totally out of line and unnecessary, right? Or just very demanding or very alpha male-ish, right? But most of us normal people associate respect with love, right? If you love somebody, you're most likely to respect them. So that's definitely something to look at. Look at how you're treating your men. Look at if your man, you know, if you're disrespecting him, if you're talking at him all crazy, that's just literally the reflection of how you really feel for him. Because I can tell you the love of my life, the man that I, you know, I'm so crazy for, I can just not see myself talking to him all crazy, right? First of all, he ain't having that shit, first of all. Second of all, yeah, that's just unnecessary. It's unladylike. And deep down inside, if you are that woman, that demanding woman, that strifeful woman, right, spiteful woman, then I can almost tell you that your man right now has no respect for you. Yes, he may love you, but how can he respect you if you don't respect him, right? How can he give it to you if you don't give it to him? And if you are continuing to disrespect him, that your man is probably having a hard time relying on you or trusting you. I mean, if you really think about it, really turn into your own relationship and look how things are on a daily basis. Are things strifeful? Are things peaceful? Are things, you know, always aggressive? It's hard to love and trust and respect somebody like that. So always look at it from the inside, look in the mirror and see if you are the one who's causing, you know, the strife. First of all, if a man's partner doesn't respect his plans or his decisions or his missions in life, then he will find it very difficult to be himself and to be the loving man and the caring man and supportive and provider that he, you know, is destined to be. It's very hard to do that when you have somebody like that, when you're in a relationship with someone like that. So make sure you get that attitude in check, or I'm telling you, my man's might end up finding it somewhere else. Hopefully not. I mean, like I said, a lot of us aren't married, but still, you always have to think about that because we're not perfect. All right, tip number three. What our men needs most but won't admit it. Well, my husband has no problem admitting it, but most of the time, it's a sexual connection. So men and women both connect through sex and communication. Women usually connect better through communication, while men usually connect better through sex. No, it doesn't mean men have to have sex to feel emotionally connected, even though a lot of them play that, right? And that's just simply because men are wired differently. They are wired that way. Just have a difficult time communicating or using their words or using their feelings, right? But I will honestly say men do have a more difficult time opening up or being emotional, you know, without any sex, right? It's hard for them. It's seriously hard for them. When you look at it, it's kind of vice versa. Women, you know, women find it harder to be sexually connected without that emotional connection first, right? And men are the opposite, right? They need the sex first to feel that sort of connection. I know I'm not just saying, oh, give your body away just to have your man open up to you, especially if you guys aren't married, right? Especially if you guys aren't married yet. I'm really talking to real couples who have hit all the pinnacles in a relationship and now just want to take it a little bit further and be a little more connected. And I do this all the time. I ask my husband all the time, you know, how can we spice things up? What is it, you know, am I fulfilling you? And, you know, it's all about communicating and it is all about that sexual connection too. So even though he's not saying it, he's almost always going to want that first, you know, before having a conversation. Okay. I'm just being real because I know how my husband is and we know how men are. So talk to your partner. Ask them specifically what makes them feel the most love, what makes them feel the most attracted, you know, from you, so that we can avoid any sexual tension, right? We don't want that connection to be, you know, disrupted any longer. So it's definitely important to talk to your partner about that and all of his sexual preferences and needs and all of that good stuff, because I'm pretty sure he got some unfulfilled. All right, my next tip of what men need most but won't say it, won't admit it, and that is emotional intimacy. Yes, our men too. For very long, men were taught to hide their emotions, water down their emotions, and to avoid just appearing weak. So we as women, and as his wife, and as a spouse, and his partner, we are his safe place. We're his safe place to fall and to let him be vulnerable whenever he needs it. Whenever he exposes some of those cracks, you know, just in his aura or his armor, right? It's up to us as his partner, as a spouse, to heal and to help him emotionally. But they also need to know that that space is even available to them. You wouldn't believe how many relationships where the spouses are just completely disconnected. The spouses completely, you know, have no connection anymore. Can't even form a simple conversation. I know people and spouses who live on two different parts of the house and stay on two different parts of the house for, you know, throughout the day and throughout weeks and years and, you know, and it's crazy to me. But I understand a lot of men, you know, aren't as emotional either. So, and just like women takes a little more time to open up sexually in a relationship, men is the same way emotionally. It might take them a little bit longer to open up and to, you know, get warmed up inside. And that's where we come in, you know, as spouses and as partners, to make sure he knows it's okay to cry in front of us. It's okay to open up his heart and his feelings into us, you know. And I just love that connection that me and my husband has formed. Like, there's nothing that we can't say to each other. There's nothing that we can't bond over, you know. And I think that's very important to build, you know, upon in a relationship. So yeah, our men need that emotional connection as well. And not criticism, not his downfalls, not everything he didn't do right, you know. That's a whole nother video, but I just wanted to throw that out there. All right, my next tip that men really do need, I think each party needs in a relationship, and that is space. Yes, it's proven that women are usually the ones who wants to spend the most time in relationships. It's proven. And the male is the one who usually wants that little bit of space and little bit of time apart, which is understandable. And I'm here to tell you, there's really no perfect balance or no really, you know, it only what works for you guys. You guys know if you're spending enough time or not spending enough time together, it's really time to reevaluate what you guys are doing on a daily basis together. Okay, you guys spent the whole week together, literally indoors, you know, watch the movies, play the games, then that's fine. Maybe, you know, maybe he wants to hang out with his boy for the weekend, or he wants to go with his family for the weekend. I'm not sure. And then vice versa. You know, maybe you guys were kind of been busy all week, and then maybe it's time to come back together to get that closeness back. But believe it or not, blowing him up, calling him, stalking him, all that crazy ish that we just need to know the location, we need to know where he is, we need to know what he's doing. I mean, if you need to be that concerned, you need to chase after him like that, then you don't need to be with him. It ain't even worth all of the energy and, you know, all of that, trying to figure out what he's doing and got going on. You know, your man should be trustworthy. You should give him the benefit of the doubt if he's worthy. Like I said, the same for Marquise and Boo Boo and Ray Ray. Okay, I'm talking about good men, good relationships, you know, salvageable relationships, and sometimes can be fixed with just a little bit of space, okay? We all need that time to miss each other, okay? Because I don't know about you, but I need all my time to myself, because not only do I spend all my time with hubby, I have 4 children that I have to, you know, expend my time on, you know, and share my time with. So time alone is definitely important. A little bit of space is definitely important. I do all types of stuff when hubby is gone or at work or, you know, doing his own thing. So space is definitely important. All right, tip number 6 on what men needs most but will never admit, and that is physical touch. Men also needs frequent, non-sexual touches, okay? Rubbing a man's feet or back after a long day at work, or coming up behind him, I do this all the time, or coming up behind him just to kiss him on the neck, or to, you know, wrap your arms around him, can be just as fulfilling, you know, as going 3 rounds in a bedroom, right? So touches like that is interpreted as physical love, right? All of that, all those endorphins and hormones are registering in his brain, like, I love you, I care for you, and I want you to feel happy and feel loved all the time. So just imagine when they come up and do that to us, how it makes us feel. They just need the same thing in return. I think he would really, really appreciate that. And last but not least, tip number 7 is security. Just like we need that from him, but security goes so much deeper than just the fact that, oh, I won't leave you, or, you know, we're together forever. He also feels secure in knowing you approve of him, him and his career, him and his choices, him and his house decisions. He feels secure and loved when you touch him, you know, non-sexually, through just throughout the day. He feels secure and loved when he's just able to feel like a man and to be the man of the house, or in the relationship, I should say. He feels secure in that, okay, and not have to check in every 30 minutes, or give his whereabouts every 20 minutes, or have to explain this. Like, I would never do that to my husband. I hope he never ever gives me that reason to feel that way, but it's just something about doing that. It's just something about women doing that that it's just so sad, and it's just so, you know, so not cute, okay? If you want a real man, a real spiritual, God-fearing man, you will never, ever, ever have to deal with anything like that, right? So I encourage you to look within your relationship itself, to look at your man himself and see, you know, if he's giving you that same type of security, if he's giving you a reason to do all of these wonderful things, if he's giving you a reason to, you know, not do all of that. Then if not, then yeah, he's more than willing, he's more than deserving of all of these little tips. And I know a lot of these are self-explanatory, but I really feel like a lot of times we have to remind ourselves, we have to remember to do some of these things or not do some of these things. So yeah, those are just some 7 tips that I came up with that I really thought would be helpful, that I really thought would kind of get us ladies back on track and putting our men first, and always remembering and thinking about him while he's out there working, while he's out there providing, and all of that good stuff. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a big old thumbs up. Don't forget to turn on your notification bell button. Please don't leave without subscribing. I will have more men, husby, self-care, you know, videos and things like that. So I really hope this was helpful. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.